Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and on today's video, we're going to be looking at recovering silver from some lead wheel weights. I got these from the scrap yard. You can take a look here. These are the things that clip onto your tires to help balance them. And these are typically lead. There's a little bit of antimony in there, I think, to harden them up. Some of the newer ones might be zinc. So my plan is I'm going to clip off little bits of a bunch of different wheel weights so we can get a pretty representative sample. And then I'm going to take about 300 to 350 grams. I'm going to put them in this magnesia cupel here. And what this does is when you heat up the metal, the lead melts at about 650 degrees Fahrenheit. And then the surface of the lead bead or button starts to oxidize. And when we raise the temperature up higher to about 1650 degrees, that lead oxide layer starts to melt and shed off in to the cupel, and the cupel absorbs it like a sponge. And so as the lead oxidizes, it's continually shed off, absorbed into the cupel. The lead metal itself is impervious to the cupel. And so as this a reaction continues, the button gets smaller and smaller and smaller, and this cupel fills up with the lead oxide, and you're left with the precious metals in a little tiny bead right in the center. And the precious metals stay because they won't oxidize. So silver, gold, any of the platinum group elements, they don't oxidize. All the other base metals, the antimony, copper, lead, iron, will all oxidize in this process and be absorbed in the cupel. So let's get started here. I'm just going to take some tin snips, and I'm just going to take the wheel weights, and I'm going to just clip off a little corner, just a little bit of the lead. And I'm going to do that for several of them, get them weighed out on a scale, and once we get about 300 to 350 grams, we'll put them in the cupel, and we'll get them in the furnace, and we'll start melting them and driving the lead off. Gloves. The lead is so soft, and the wheel weights are thin enough that I can just nip them off pretty easy. And it's actually amazing, you can tell just by cutting them, some of them are harder and some of them are real soft. So again, I can tell just from how hard it is to trim them that the chemistry might be a little bit different across the range of these wheel weights. And somebody asked me the other day on one of our videos, if you can recover silver from lead. And so this is a little experiment to see if that works. But I've been doing a lot of smelting videos lately, and one of the important parts for like an assay or when you're analyzing how much gold you've recovered is you want to make sure that you know the impurities in your collector metal, if you have any, such as silver. And so the idea here is take your lead, run a blank cupel, and find out how much silver weight you have, just residual in your collector metal. And then when you get your bead from your smelt or your assay, you have to subtract the amount of residual silver that's in your collector metal. So that's kind of the bigger picture here on what we're doing. And we're taking a little bit off of each wheel weight so we can get kind of a representative sample, because if we just melted down three wheel weights, there might be no lead or no silver in those, or it may be full of silver. So again, we kind of want to get a representation of a bunch of different wheel weights. There's all our lead pieces right there. So we'll take these and get them weighed. Okay, there's 300 grams of wheel weights. Here's our cupel full of our lead. And now we'll go get our electric furnace set up and get this melted down and up to temperature to shed those oxides. And here's our lead in our furnace. This is a little electric furnace. And we have exactly 300 grams in there. And it looks like a lot. I know this cupel is rated for 400 grams, 380 or something. So all that should melt down and not overflow, hopefully. Because you can see I've actually spilled a little bit of lead in this furnace. Lead oxide is real corrosive, and it eats up this kind of foam insulation pretty bad. So you want to make sure you don't spill lead all over your furnace, because that's bad. But we'll get this heating up. It heats up pretty fast. And we'll melt the lead, and we'll check back in on it once the lead's molten. So I'm just going to close the door. And when we do get up to temperature and the lead oxide melts, I'll crack this door a little bit and allow the oxygen from the air to get in and oxidize the lead. If you keep the door closed, the oxygen doesn't circulate very well and it takes forever. So we'll let that heat up and check back on it in a minute. All right, so we're molten. Ooh, boy, we almost overflowed there. But you can see it's got that kind of black scum on top. That's the lead oxide that's formed, but it's not molten yet. And we're only, well, I opened the door, so it's cooling down. But we're about 1,500 degrees. So in a couple more 100 degrees, that hopefully will start driving into the cupel. The cupel will turn kind of a dark gray or black, brown looking thing. So we'll get that up to temperature here and check back on it. Our cupel's starting to absorb some of that lead. You can see the gray spot on it. And when it first went molten, there was a bunch of junk on top. And so I kind of scraped it off to the sides. You can see it all there. And I think that's probably oxides from some of the other base metals like iron and copper and stuff. So those won't melt when there's a whole bunch of them like that. The lead can't get them all into the cupel. So I scraped them off. It looks like we got a pretty good lead bead going there, and it's drawn down into the cupel. So we'll let that go. It's been about 45 minutes or so now. So we'll let it go, and it'll probably take an hour or two to run all that lead in. But we're running right at 1,700 degrees. You can see the furnace heating back up again since I opened the door. But we're on our way, so we'll see what kind of bead we get in the bottom of that cupel. Okay, so I just switched cupels here. There's the one that was going, and it was getting pretty well to the bottom. It actually had gone to the bottom here, and I was a little worried about it getting stuck on the little plinth I had in the furnace. So I moved it over to this one, and this lead looks pretty junky. So there might be some zinc in there or something else. You know, it's not really great looking, but we'll keep cupelling it, get it all the way down to a precious metal button, hopefully, and see how much silver we have in there. And here's that first cupel. And like I said earlier, you can see there's a ring of junk around the top. And when the button first went liquid and got up to temperature, all this junk floated to the top. And my guess is that's all other base metal oxides other than lead. So, you know, maybe a little bit of copper, antimony, maybe some iron in there. But it's just all the rest of the junk that was in there that probably has a higher melting point than what we were reaching in our furnace. So what I did is I just took a little piece of wire and I scraped it all off along to the sides so the lead could get a metallic surface to the air and start to oxidize. Once I got the lead exposed, it could start cupelling, and then the button started to shrink pretty quickly. So thought that was an important part to this whole silver recovery is, you know, there's a lot of stuff in those wheel weights other than just lead. All right, we'll check on our cupel here. We should be getting pretty close. Oh yeah. So we're almost done there. Another couple of minutes at the most, and we'll have a little bead in there, hopefully. All right, I just pulled the cupel out, and there's our little bead. Right there. Looks like it's got some oxide junk on that right-hand side. But let me get the tweezers and pull it out of there and see if we can get it weighed. But cool, we got silver from wheel weights. There's our little bead.
And it looks like it weighs 0.04 grams. So we recovered 0.04 grams of silver from 300 grams of wheel weights.
So as you can see, there's not very much silver left in wheel weights. We only recovered 0.04 grams, which the math works out to be about 1/100 of a percent. Or if you extrapolate that out into a ton, if you had a ton of molten wheel weights, there's only about 3 to 4 ounces of silver in there. So about $60 worth, more or less. So you're not gonna get rich processing wheel weights for silver. But kind of the bigger picture there is if we use that lead for a collector metal for some of our smelts, we would have to subtract 0.04 grams from our button, because that's how much residual silver was left in our collector metal. So that's an important point. If you guys are starting to do some smelting on your own or are trying to do some assaying, especially if you're assaying very, very low grades, like tailings from your process or head ore that you're looking for just a little bit of silver, a little bit of gold, 0.04 grams of precious metals can make a lot of difference. And so you wanna make sure you're correcting for that. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you learned something and saw kind of a cool chemistry process in action. If you have any questions or comments, you can check out our contact information in the description below, or you can leave a comment down in the comment section. So thanks again for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.